What's up, guys? Thank you for joining. Nestor Adriansen here again. Today, I'm going to show you how to create simple and easy backgrounds for your Power BI reports. And guess what? We're going to be using just PowerPoint. No other additional designing tools, just PowerPoint. So, are you ready? Let's do this. Before we go over the steps, this is the final result. This is the green background. And then the other one is the black background. So guys, be ready. Let's do this. The first thing that you want to do here is open PowerPoint. Once you're there, go over design, and then under slide size, let's select customize slide size. Once you're there, there is an option there to customize your canvas size. And for this particular case, we're gonna be using these directions, okay? So the canvas size is gonna be 936 pixels by 1,664, because that's the canvas size in our Power BI report, so we wanna match that. And remember, we have to convert this to inches. You can use Google here to do that, but I already have this here, so we're gonna use this. For the height, we're going to be using 975 inches. So let's go over here and replace it. And then for the width, we're going to be using 1733. So let's do that. Perfect. So once we are done, let's hit OK. And then ensure fit. Boom. So now this canvas size is going to be matching our Power BI report canvas size as well. So once we are there, the next step is to start customizing this background. Let's delete this for now. And then we can even put this side by side if we want. There you go. So that's better. This is what we're gonna do here. So there are some directions here in this file on the right. Like I said, I'm gonna be sharing with you this file as well so you can follow along. So, but the background should be this color. We're going to be using this hex code. So right click here and then format background. So we're going to match this color, customizable, right? Control V, hit OK, boom. So the next step here is to insert a rectangular shape. So let's do that. We go to insert here and then let's go over here. Check this out. And then for this particular case, let's get started with a green background. So you're gonna be using this color right here, Control C. So let's select this visual again. Let's go over shape fill. And then here, more colors, same thing here. This is a custom color, Control V, hit okay, boom. Another good practice here is also for the shape outline, no outline. So the next step here is to check the dimensions. The height should be 948 inches. So let's do that. Copy this. And then as you can see, we have to paste it here. We want to change this to 948. Perfect. And then for the width, it should be 357. 357. Perfect. So now this is looking better. So we can also improve here the edges. Perfect. And then the next step here is to add another rectangular shape. So this is for the canvas. Control C, Control V. And then, so let's get started with the color first. This should be gray, light gray. Control C, shape fill. Then let's go over mold fill colors. Same thing here. Control V, hit OK, boom. And then we can expand this as well. So what are the dimensions for this one? So the height is gonna be 948, so we are good. And then the width should be 1495, almost there, 1495. So let's do that, perfect. And then we can also customize the edges here. Perfect. So that looks so much better. So we can also customize this a little bit better if we want. So this is looking better now. So we are good. And then we have to insert here 6 small shapes. All right, so let's do that. We're gonna be copying this and pasting this. Control C, Control V. And then this should be a little bit lighter, okay? Let's go over here. And then let's select this one right here. Perfect. And we also have dimensions here, as you might remember. So let's check this out. That should be 2 inches by 2 inches. Okay, so let's do that. This should be 2 by 2. Perfect. So let's modify a little bit the edges here. Perfect. And then we have to create at least 6. Let's do that. Control C, Control V. So we're gonna be copying and pasting here 6 times. Perfect. And remember that we have to leave a space here for the title. Let's go over here like this. And then we can also align this better. So let's select all of them. There is an option here, align. So horizontally. And then the next step here is to the middle. Perfect. So we are good there. And then we need to have 2 big rectangular shapes. So let's do that. Control C, Control V. So what are the dimensions for this one? So we have there 622 by 446. So let's do that. So we are good here. And we need 2 of this. Control C, Control V. 2 of this. Perfect. And the next step here is to create 2 additional small rectangular shapes. So let's do that. Control C, Control V. Perfect. So once we are here, for the height, it should be 3 inches. So 3 inches, perfect. And then for the width, we are good. Control C, Control V. Let's copy and paste it here. So we don't have to do the work twice. This is looking better, guys. And then if you want, you can also rearrange this a little bit better. So in that way, this looks so much nicer. Perfect. We are almost done, guys. So let's minimize this for now and maximize this one right here. The next step here is to insert additional icons here. So let's go over to insert. As you can see, there is an option here called icons. Let's go over here and let's start inserting a few icons to enrich this canvas. So let's type here profit and let's select this visual right here. Insert. So this is the icon that we care about. And then we can also make a little bit smaller if we want. Awesome. So let's keep working, guys. Let's look for something different here. Insert again, icons. Money, and let's see what we get. Perfect. So let's get this icon right here again. Insert. It's gonna be right here. Perfect. Let's keep going here. Insert again. Icon. So let's try money here again and let's see what we get. Let's insert this one right here. Perfect. Let's keep going, guys. This is fun. So let's look for taxes here. Our favorite topic, taxes. Let's insert this. Perfect. Let's keep going. Insert. Let's type here transportation. There you go. Let's try this one right here. Perfect. Let's keep going, guys. Almost there. Icons here. And then let's hit update. So once we are here, let's select this one right here. Perfect. So we are good. And then the next thing that we can do here is to customize this as well. So let's select that. So let's select those icons again, hold down control. And then once you are there, let's go to graphics field and let's select green. How about that? Looks awesome, right? And then guys, we are done. So let's save these changes. This is also a cool part here. Save a copy. So this is critical, my friends. We're gonna use the scalable vector graphics format. If we do that, so the background is gonna be high quality. So let's select this and save this, just this one, boom. So now let's open the Power BI report, and I'm gonna be sharing this report with you as well. The next thing that we wanna do here, well, this is actually black background. So if we go back to PowerPoint, we can duplicate this real quick. Check this out. Control C, Control V. And then, so we can do this for a black background as well. So this is going to be quite straightforward. So let's select this shape for now. And then for the black background, this is the hex code. Remember that? This is the black shape. And then fill, more fields, and then we're gonna copy and paste this here. Hit okay, boom. And then for these icons, so let's select them again, and guess what? We're gonna be selecting which color? Probably this color right here. So that looks so much better, right? And then let's maximize this again. We can save this as well, save a copy. And then if you want, you can specify here, this should be black. So this is gonna be black backgrounds for Power BI report. And then remember, here we need to use the scalable vector graphics. Save again, and let's see how it goes. Just this one, boom. So now, if we go back to the Power BI report, we can definitely use that. Check this out. So we are here, this is our report that we already built. The next step here is to go over the canvas background. So once we are here, here's where the magic starts. Let's go over here again. So there is the black backgrounds for Power BI report that we just created. Select this one, hit open, and let's see what happens. Boom. So we have to make a couple of adjustments here. We can do that without any issue. Just adjust this one right here. And then this is perfect. And then we can also do that for the other pieces. Perfect, we have to center this. We are good to go, my friends. And then you can start playing with these. Check this out. So let's say that we care about this month. You can see the results right there. So it is working perfectly fine. Let's see that we care about central. There you go, nothing for central. And then let's say that we care about friends for that particular month. We do have data there, and you can see the results there. You can also delete all slicers, hold down control, delete all slicers, boom. So it's working. So now for the green background, we can duplicate this as well. And check this out, it's gonna take a few seconds. And here, let's change this to green background. So let's see how it works. So once we are here, so let's remove this background. And the next step is to import the previous one, the first one that we just created. Let's hit open and let's see what happens. Boom, there it is. It's working perfectly fine, my friend. So once we are here, we can also modify the color for this one. Let's go to bars here. And this should be green, light green, green right here. So we can do the same for this visual as well. So in that way, this matches your background colors as well. Same here for this. Green, green, green right there. Awesome. And there you have it, my friend. Really, really powerful way to create nice backgrounds. All right, guys, there you have it. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. Please leave your questions and comments below. And of course, don't forget to subscribe if you don't want to miss anything. Also, check out these tutorials out if you want to keep sharpening your Power BI skills. Thank you guys for your time and see you next time.